Good evening. Welcome to 15-4 Challenge.
Good evening.
It's 7 o'clock on a Wednesday night. Do you know where your challenge is? Raise your right hand. That's not your right hand.
It is my
no,
right
it's
hand.
Not. Look, it's not your right hand.
It doesn't look like it, but it really is.
That's so weird.
I feel a little discombobulated.
You are discombobulated.
Well, good, that's how I feel. All right, so we're going to start off with our paradiddles. And of course, if you're painting, go ahead and practice your paint-a-diddles. That'll tighten up naturally.
Okay.
And it'll get to the point where you won't even have to do the duck so much.
Well, the duck is now a natural duck.
Yeah, it's a natural
I have a natural duck. It's like I'm a duck and a pterodactyl mixed.
Does that mean you're a pterodactyl or a duck-a-ractyl?
A duck-a-ractyl.
That's what I kind of
thought. Because it's so much more fun to say. So, just so in case you guys didn't know. Hi! So in case you guys didn't know, I'm not being like all creepy and American Gothic when I'm like looking into the camera like this. I'm like, I'm watching myself so that I can kind of improve what I'm doing. What do you think? Jesse's like the bad little boy in school sitting behind you dipping your fucking pigtails into the ink well. Of course.
Really? Inkwell?
Can you tell my favorite movie is Anne of Green Gables?
That's what it's done. I didn't even have inkwells when I went to school.
Better you be careful, it might break its light over your head.
I think what we'll do is we will just roll right hand, left hand.
Okay.
So it'll be.
I'm gonna go slower because, like, oh my god, you cannot even hear that. Is that how it's supposed to be? No, it's supposed to be louder than that, isn't it?
Well, if you do it the Rocky way, she actually puts her she picks her thumb up. Put your thumb on the ring so she sits like that.
So every time she rolls, she picks her hand up like that?
Well, again, I think, you know, when you first start learning, everything is very over-exaggerated and you have to pull it in. It's just like, you know, we're doing this, but in actuality, it's this.
It's that.
Yeah, so it's at this point, what we're doing is we're building finger strength here.
Right. Does she have in one of her books? Does she explain the finger
roll? She does that in the video that we
watched. Oh, she does. Can I see that part?
Yeah. This is where you go, oops. Oops, amazing.
Oops, oops.
Thank you. Now there's another exercise that you can do too, where you do four. Yeah, you can do that. Yeah, that's more. Doesn't really help your strumming at all, but you can. Where you do, you count a four and you accent the one. So it'll be one, two, three, four, one, two, three. No, you're just going back to that second. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3. It's like it rolls the one through.
Oh.
1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3.
We'll have to go much slower.
Yeah, this is a little more difficult. But the idea of this is to be able to accent the individual finger. But again, that's more of a mind thing than a stroke thing, because you gotta be able to do that. Alright, so now we'll move on to Matsum.
Okay.
And
let's do each one four times. How did you know to say that?
That's a very common thing.
Do you understand common? Oh no, I have to see it because I don't remember the second
see
one.
See it? You can't see that. What's the fourth one?
The fourth one of what? The fourth thing on there is Baladi.
Maybe you can't see.
Why do you think it's because
you can't see that.
No, it's far away. It's like smaller print than this even.
Ready? this on the table.
I don't think my hand is big enough.
There you go. You're putting your fingers into this part, not your thumb.
Oh.
Let me see that part of your hand.
Like that?
Yeah, like that. You can tuck your pinky in. This finger right here is there. It's just barely hanging on. It feels like it's always going to just
fly
out.
It's the English finger. It's English, this one.
This finger.
I'm a little English bird.
But no, this finger here always feels like it's just going to fall out. You have to hit it right away because it's going to fall out.
But you should, that's not going to fall out.
You should be able to tuck these two fingers in there where they feel like they'll
stay.
This set.
One's tucked in, so it'll stay too. It's not going to fall out.
But see, now put your thumb out more. Now tuck them in there so they don't fall out.
Well, screw you in the falling
dig
fingers.
Dig your finger into the, what is it, Mount Olympus or whatever they call that?
What?
Before when you do your hand reading, that what? Mount Olympus?
I don't know. I'm not hand reading.
So what you want to do is you want to put your thumb down like that. And then put your fingers in there, and you want to be able to. You're never going to get this one to be super loud. You're never going to get these two to be super loud. So.
Oh. Ooh, it's more of a reality now.
See, now when you come out with your hand, you're coming out with your hand like, say, your hand's here. You're coming out with your hand.
Don't
do that.
Do that.
No, that's kind of. I'm exaggerating a little bit.
Which way are you rolling?
This one. So it helps have your hand here because it gives you something to push your hand off on.
I did it!
Yeah, you know what I mean though? By pushing on the drum. By pushing on the drum, you have something to push against. When you're out here, you can do it, but it's like trying to push off in water. You know what I mean? Well, that didn't work. So now do the break part where it's
still. Is that right?
Yeah. I mean, I'm gonna follow, but I can't do it when we're going like top speed with you.
There you go. Still trying to think about it.
I'm not thinking.
That's the key thing is you want to be able to just feel it or know it. You don't want to think it. Because when you think it, that makes you slow down.
I know you and feel you all the time.
Well, we hope you've enjoyed this 15-4 challenge episode. We hope you're doing the challenge, whether it's drumming or something else. Again, it's all about taking the time to a little portion of your day to learn something and get better.
I'm really actually enjoying doing this. I can already feel myself becoming better, and it really has not been that long. Just the tenacity of making the commitment and doing it for such a short amount of time every day. Like, if you watch the first video, or if you watch, like, some of the Rhythm Soup videos where I'm playing the Doumbek, I have, like, improved, like, a million-fold since then, and it's only been a couple weeks. Mm-hmm. So, we really hope that you guys are challenging yourself as well. And, be good, be better, do good stuff. Bye.
See ya.